covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News, First at 4.
There have been so many burglaries on the Treasure Coast, police are now becoming victims themselves. Thank you for staying with us. I'm Tiffany Kenny. Felicia Rodriguez is off today. Meredith McDonough picks up the story from Port St. Lucie.
Port St. Lucie police tell us that there have been nearly 400 burglaries, both homes and cars, since October. And it seems even law enforcement is not exempt.
They took my police uniforms. For what reason, I have no idea.
Palm Beach County Sheriff's Deputy Louis Colon is the latest victim in a string of burglaries in Port St. Lucie. His home was broken into early Sunday morning.
They busted open this door, bashed it in. There was glass everywhere.
Colon says seeing pictures of him in uniform didn't stop these guys from taking what they wanted.
Gun, a rifle, jewelry, stereo equipment. Games, Xbox game.
Police say the suspects even stole Cologne's SUV and left it at this abandoned home. The car's LoJack device was activated and led police here. Crime scene investigators with Port St. Lucie police were able to lift fingerprints from the car, back door of the house, and even a jewelry box.
This is an excellent quality print because it's almost like it was just placed there.
This is how many points we had in common.
Police ran the prints and arrested 18-year-old Peter Harris and 17-year-old Terrence Walker. They found the two hiding under the covers at one of the suspects' homes. A relief for Deputy Colon, especially since his uniforms and rifle were in the wrong hands. Yes,
well, that's one thing that I was afraid of getting the bad guy getting a gun or a weapon to be used against us, the law enforcement community.
And according to this police report, both suspects are known gang members and have prior arrests. In Port St. Lucie, Meredith McDonough, WPBF 25 News.